sponsor pro wrestler. Yeah. I hand it to him. That is delicate. Yeah. That is inspired.
Yeah, and piping a little bit of wasabi
there you
into
go.
That.
There you go.
Beautiful piece of tuna. I've got to do something with it.
Look, Iron Chef's just cutting the roll now. Very much has the appearance of a sushi roll, but obviously with that sort of Korean flavouring to it. Looks lovely.
Over here on the main courses, Marcus is just skinning a bit of salmon here, and I suspect he's going to use the salmon as the filling for his, or as the base for his ravioli. So he's going to process the salmon down and then fold through the crab meat. Kind of classic way. Yeah, in fact, he's just dicing that up.
Beautiful.
Ready to go into the food processor. Or he may even just hand dice it.
So you're right, he's chopping by hand. Marcus chopping by hand.
Marcus, he's chopping that salmon really finely. Yep, that isn't, as we predicted, going into a bowl with the crab and the fresh herbs and the
you
seasoning
like the look of that. You think
in there. Yeah, I do like the look of that.
You said earlier on, you know, you favoured, you thought possibly a dish of the day there. You still sticking with that?
Yeah, it very much depends on that pasta.
Here we've got Gareth beavering away with his main course. Now, he's making a chili coconut crab gratin with linguine pasta, so I'm not sure how that's all going to come together. Gratin, of course, is traditionally served in the vessel it's cooked in, so where's he going to put the linguine? On the side or the top or what? Don't know what the judges are going to make of that. He's not been doing too badly on points so far this week, but still no dish of the day star for him. Over on the starters, and plating up is well underway now with very little time left.
Angie, can you check the spring roll, please?
Judy, it's good.
Get the lime leaf out for garnish, please.
Yeah, sure.
The Iron Chef is actually working in good time today.
Yeah, and Sudhar's got his he's got his balsamic run out on the plate. He started to put together his salad. What he's got at one end is he's got that little plum, spiced plum chutney that he made sitting in a little ring. And here comes the rest of the salad. We've got bits of fresh things. I think we've got some apples and pears and fresh herbs in there. Peter is putting together his cocktail.
In a bit of a martini glass.
Yes. On the bottom, we've got the lettuce puree. Then we've got the gazpacho on top of that. Remember, we've still got his deep-fried spring rolls, which is going to be his crunch. Sudhar making a very nice canal of crab going on there.
And
here comes the Mary Rose foam or mousse on top of the gazpacho. I don't know, do you know, I'm just missing texture from that dish.
Yeah, but bear in mind he's a wrestler and he can probably hear you.
1 minute remaining.
I love
the lack of texture in that dish. Lovely little spring rolls here from Iron Chef Judy Jew.
Better get on the, okay, on well, the pass and we've got Iron Chef Judy
suddenly
Jew
Suddenly the time's run
up.
Away. Judy Jew's got her first dish on there. Peter's got his crab cocktail and that little side dish with the spring roll and his version of a tomato rose. The second dish is coming up from Iron Chef Peter Jew. There's a little bit of a kind of loop going on there.
We're doing sushi. Can we get it all? Hang on, we need Sudhar.
Listen, we're 2 seconds here. We're missing a dish. Sudhar is there on time.
Just in transit.
Iron Chef Judy Jew is going back to her roots with her first starter of Korean crab kimbap, seaweed rolls stuffed with rice, crab, flying fish roe, and egg with a chili and brown crab dip. Her second starter is a turmeric and saffron spiced soup of brown crab and coconut milk served with crispy velvet crab spring rolls and a crab skewer. Challenger Peter has created an inventive crab cocktail. Layers of lettuce puree, spicy gazpacho, crab cream and Mary Rose foam served in a martini glass. Challenger Sudha's starter is a gently spiced crab and coconut salad with a lime chili and salmon mousse served with plum chutney and crunchy fruit salsa.
So it's crab on the menu in Kitchen Stadium today and the tide has brought in the starters. What will the judges make of the effort so far? Find out after the break. Welcome back to Iron Chef UK, where here in Kitchen Stadium, it's Battle Crab. While Marcus and Gareth get on with their mains, it's judgment time for the starters. So without further ado, let's eat. Iron Chef Judy Jew, how was the heat of battle?
It's good. This crab is very challenging, but I think we got it done. It's good.
Fabulous. So could you tell us your dish number one, please?
Yes,
your
dish
starter.
Number one. Looks like sushi, but please don't call it sushi. It's actually Korean, and it's called kimbap. Use your fingers. Eat it in one bite. Dip it in the crab chili sauce and tell me what you think. There's basically crab in there that's been spiced a little bit. Hope you think so, with a little bit of heat. I've got some seasoned spinach, takwan, which is a vinegared pickled radish. And then I've got some carrots in there and egg. Nice medley of flavours. Enjoy.
What do you think?
Well, a jewel on a plate. I mean, it just looked superb. The little teardrops or lotus. And I love, in the crab, that sort of certain bite of, what is it?
That's
sort
you're
of
taking
egg.
The tobiko, yes, the flying fish roe. That's a nice little burst of flavour.
Mm. Gorgeous.
Andy?
Well, it looks absolutely stunning on the plate and it tastes equally stunning. So I think it's a delicate flavour, but it's very seafoody and it's nothing like that I've had before. I'd have perhaps a slightly more pronounced crab flavour, but it's, you know, it's complex.
Crab is a very
dish.
Subtle flavour, yeah, though. Subtle.
And I think the rice, I might have made that just slightly sort of sharper in...
Well, the Korean rice, we don't put vinegar in it.
You don't?
We do not, no. It's not Japanese.
I stand corrected
so,
then.
We season it strictly with a hint of sesame oil, just a kiss of it, and some sesame seeds.
Iron Chef Judy Jew, could you please tell us about your second starter?
Second starter, I've actually pulled my inspiration from Southeast Asia. Basically, there's a crab spring roll there. We've got a soup there that's made with coconut milk, a lot of turmeric, some saffron. Hope you get a taste of Southeast Asia in one bite. And I actually encourage you to dip those little crab spring rolls into the soup because I like to mix all my food together. It kind of tastes dirty when you get involved with your flavors and get involved with your food.
Muck in there.
Yeah. Oh, great. Bold. This is a much sort of bolder dish. And the texture as you dip in there and the sort of crunchiness and then the crab coming through. And I love the way that the crab has been worked into the soup. And when I thought coconut crab, is it going to be a bit heavy? But no, it's got a gorgeous lightness about it. I like
it. Fantastic. Andy?
I love that you get the texture of the flakes of crab meat so prominent to that. And then you've got the spicy element to it. And it's creamy and it's a real wow.
Excellent.
A real
thank
wow.
You.
Smashing. Iron Chef Judy Jew, thank you. If I could fling
thank
you back
you.
Into the arena.
Thank you. I'm
and
off.
Judges, thank you. It is now time to bring forth our challengers. Peter, how did you enjoy the sizzle of Kitchen Stadium?
Thoroughly enjoyed that. We're getting into stride now, so...
Love it. Well, tell us what you have strode forth with in your
this
first
This is
dish.
A... Give me a second, guys. This is a homage to the 1970s. This is a straight out of Trust House 40 crab cocktail, a crab cannoli. All the way at the bottom there, you've got a lettuce puree coming up through a spicy gazpacho with white crab meat in it. And the top is an infused cream with crab and lemongrass. On the side, that's a little sashimi of tuna, wasabi paste in the middle there, salt and pepper. Enjoy.
Well, judges, a time-travelling dish, a happy journey.
Sorry
about
that.
Some shell.
Yeah, it's a bit dodgy to the dentures, it might be.
Checked it, go now, got in there.
I love the fact that it's referencing the 70s, and so it's a bit of fun and highly original, and you know there's good crab flavour in there, so it's really good.
Well, I was going to say, Peter, you've done it again in that, you know, nothing straightforward for you. I mean, looking at it sort of straight on, the layers, and then ending it up with a sort of bit of foamy cream, and you know he's got a wonderful sort of imagination. But I still say to Peter that perhaps less is more and concentrate on simplifying but getting more intensity of flavours.
Lovely. Peter, thank you very much.
Thank
Suda,
you.
Did you enjoy yourself today?
Yes, very much. The buzz, the busyness.
And what was your dish?
It's a combined dish. It should go through anti-clockwise. First is a spicy salmon mousse and with some lime leaves. And then goes the crab salad with spice and coconut milk. And to give it extra balance of flavor, make some plum chutney, spicy plum chutney. And when you go towards the end, that's a salsa. So it cleans your palate and ready for the main course. That's the concept is. So you should be eaten at last.
I love the way that they sit on the plate, the three like that, and it looks sort of like an artist's palette. And the salmon, I thought was great, but we're meant to be tasting crabs. Then move on to the crab. And actually,